Astronomy. This is our first unit in Earth Science. Look at this, and what do you see the Earth doing? You see it rotating, right? One of our first focus is going to be the Earth's rotation. Well, rotation is the spinning of the Earth on its own axis. Did we say go around the sun? No. The Earth rotates on its axis. Okay? This is giving us day and night. So, as the Earth spins, the closer that we're to the sun, we have morning. The farther, when we turn away from the sun, we have night. So the sun rises in the east and sets in the west, right? The moon does, it said, as do the moon. So the moon does the same thing. Planets and stars as a result of the Earth's rotation. Okay? Because as we rotate everything that was on that side, if you did a 180 degree turn, you're going to see everything that was previously behind you, right? When you turn back around, that's called a 360. The Earth goes in a 360. So the Earth rotates. Rotation is about 23 hours and 56 minutes. That's why we call it a 24-hour day. One thing we have to understand is basically the Earth's precession. Well, precession is a vocabulary word, and it is gravity-induced, slow and continuous change in the orientation of the Earth's rotational axis. It takes about 26,000 years to come to a completion. Okay? So, this right here, 26,000 years of Earth's axis of rotation completes a circle. Okay? Where we at right here, as you see, the North Star now is here, and it says the Vega, the North Star, in the year 14,000. So approximately 12,000 years from now, the Earth's axis rotation will line up with Vega. Okay, so I don't think nobody's going to be here 12,000 years from now. This will change the view of the stars from the poles, but it will never affect our seasons, as in the sun, spring, winter, and fall. Earth's nutation. So what is nutation? So in addition to causing tides, the moon's orbit around the Earth also causes the Earth to nod or bob throughout periods called a nutation. Sometimes you ever was on a roller skate and or a bicycle or anything, and you kind of ran over like a small rock or anything, and it kind of just made you a little bit off balance, but you didn't lose balance. That's basically what happens to the Earth. Happens about in about every 18 years. The direction of the tilt basically by a half a degree, so it's not very big. And this is sometimes why we may have more of a hotter summer or colder winter, or a warmer winter versus a colder summer, because it will slightly increase or decrease the amount of the seasonal effects. So again, this is called nutation. So nutation, what really is it though? So I did tell you we have the little area that happens. So precision again is for us to make this full, complete, like perfect circle. But nutation is the little bumps in the roads around the time. The main cause is gravitational torque of the moon, sun, and the planets. So the Earth's equilateral bulge. So the Earth has an equilateral bulge of 42.72 kilometers. And that's due because of the constant rotation. And constant, again, is means continuously. That diameter is measured across the equilateral plane And it's about, again, as we said, 42.72 kilometers more than the measure between the poles, okay? You just have to remember what this bulge is. So now we talked about the rotation of the Earth. Now we have to talk about the revolution of the Earth. So revolution is the time it takes for an object to complete an orbit around another orbit. So this is how, when we say the Earth revolves around the sun doesn't revolve around us. We go around the sun. It takes 365 days, okay, to go around the sun. So quick quiz for you. How long does it take for the Earth to rotate? 24 hours. How long does it take for the Earth to revolve? 365 days. In a combination with the tilt of the Earth's axis, revolution is responsible for our annual changes. So this is why we have long summers or we have short winters. That is why. So the reason why we have seasons is because of this right here. The Earth is not sitting straight up, okay? The Earth is actually tilted, and it's tilted at 23.5 degrees, all right? So as we're tilted, this is what causes the seasons to change. So the tilt is the reason for the seasons. So more direct sunlight obviously gives us warmer temperatures. This is why we call it the summer. During the winter, our hemisphere is tilted away from the sun. So that means we're going to be colder because we're not closer to the sun. So now you have to understand the solstice. So we have a summer solstice. And that is where it's the highest altitude in the sky, and that's always June 21st around there. And that gives us the number of days of maximum of daylight sun. So when we get June 21st, it's supposed to be like, that's what we always gonna be like, that's the first day of summer. But that is why, okay? Winter solstice is when the sun is at its lowest altitude in the sky. So again, if you look here, summer solstice is always June 21st. And as you see, the Earth up here on this side is closest to the sun. The winter, the other side of the Earth that was close to the sun is now farther from the sun, and that allows us to have, like, it started getting dark at 5 o'clock at night. Equinox. So we just talked about the solstice. Now we got to talk about the equinox. So we have two positions that the Earth is not pointing at the sun. And this is when we both get the same amount of sunlight pretty much on both sides of the hemisphere, okay? So this right here is when the sun is directed over the equator. Equator is the red line. So basically, this is why we have mild temperatures in the spring and fall, because neither hemisphere is pointed at the sun. So that's why in the spring, it kind of be, sometimes it can be like 50, maybe 60, and the same thing in fall. So we call it equal. So equinox means equal. So we have equal amount of time with the temperatures, because again, we're not pointed at the sun during this time. The sun. The sun's structures